Now let's discuss about the production of X-rays. We already discussed that X-rays are produced when fast-moving electrons strike a suitable target anode in the Cooley's tube, and due to the breaking of electrons, the kinetic energy is transformed into X-rays. Now here we'll discuss that on the basis of production mechanism, which we are going to discuss soon, on the basis of production mechanism, X-rays are classified in two broad categories. If we talk about X-rays, these are classified in two categories. The very first is continuous X-rays, and the second one is characteristic X-rays. Now, these are produced again by breaking of electrons in the discharge tube, as we already discussed in the previous section. The basic difference is one accelerated electron in a vacuum tube strike the anode and it is further accelerated due to the strong electric field of nucleus in the anode. Then the kinetic energy of electron is radiated as continuous X-rays. These are called continuous X-rays because the spectrum of the X-rays which are emitted due to the strong electric field of nucleus is continuous, or we can say that the wavelength emitted of these X-rays are varying from a very low value to a very high value. That's why the spectrum is continuous, and due to this such X-rays are called continuous X-rays. If we talk about characteristic X-rays, we can say when high energy electrons strike any of the orbiting electrons, of the anode atom and it knocks out these electrons. We know that this knocking out process is possible only when the high energy electron possesses an amount of energy which is more than the binding energy of these electrons. So if it is more than during collision, it is possible that these orbiting electrons can be knocked out, and due to the vacancy created, we can say it result in emission of a line spectrum of the element. This line spectrum wavelengths are called characteristic X-rays, and as for a given element of which the anode is made up of, there are some specified wavelengths which are emitted. That's why these are called characteristic X-rays. And in case of breaking of electron by the strong electric field of nucleus, almost all wavelengths are emitted from the surrounding of nucleus when various electrons are fired. That's why the spectrum is continuous and these are called continuous X-rays. In coming sections, we will discuss about the production mechanism of both of these X-rays in detail.